reside in. But it's more interesting to think about clinical characteristics. So I'm going to show you some examples of mainly focusing on ADLs for the slide across different care settings. So what we have here is long-stay home care clients receiving community-based home care services. And we have the neurological conditions that we're interested in, stroke, MS, epilepsy, Parkinson's, Alzheimer's-related dementia, traumatic brain injury, Huntington's, spinal cord injury, ALS, muscular dystrophy, and cerebral palsy. And what we have is the distribution of the ADL hierarchy scale that Intro-I developed. People who are zero are independent in four major ADLs, but people who are a five or six are the most impaired in those ADLs, including late loss ADLs. And what you see, first of all, is that the general population of people in home care settings, about 80% of them are independent, compared to in the neurological population, less than 50%. But between neurological subgroups, you see quite a bit of variability. So people with cerebral palsy, only about 30% there are independent in ADLs, and 30% are severely impaired in ADLs. For the dementia population, about half in home care are a zero on that ADL hierarchy scale, and about 15 or 18% are in the 3-plus range. So persons with neurological conditions show more impairment in ADLs, but there's diversity between neurological subgroups. Now what I'm going to do is move you into the next care setting with the same diagnostic subgroups and just focus on the changes in the relative sizes of the different colored areas.